Hello guys, and welcome to Python Programming Tutorials by Amul's Academy. In the previous tutorial, we discussed about the lambda function and map function. Today, in this tutorial, we are discussing about the filter and reduce function. First, we'll see what is filter function. So, as name indicates, this filter function will filter the element of the iterables based on some function. Okay, so this filter function is used to filter the unwanted elements. First, we'll see the syntax of this filter function. First, we need to mention the filter. Next, here we need to mention function. Next, here we need to mention the iterables. Okay. So this filter function will return the element from this iterables for which this function will become true. So this function will return true or false. Okay. When this function will return true for any value of this iterable, that value will be returned by this filter function. So if you are still confused, then don't worry. We'll take the example so you'll understand better. So for example, in 1 to 10 number, you want to print all the even numbers. So for that, what will you do is you'll use for loop, right? So we can write like this: for x in range 1 to 11. 11 because I want to print all the even numbers from 1 to 10. So I'll mention 1 to 11 here. And I'll check if, right? So we'll get all the even numbers from 1 to 10. The same thing can be done by another method, that is using filter method. And using single line code, we can get this output. So for that, we need to use filter function. So here I need to mention filter. Next, here first I need to mention the function. So here I'll take lambda function. So my key will be lambda. Next, I'll take argument as x, and next I'll write expression like this. Okay, so next iterable is range from 1 to 11. I need to close this. I'll enter. Here we can see we got the filter object as the output. Okay, so in Python 3, this filter function will return filter object. If you want to see the output in the list form, then you can use list constructor and you can get the output in the list form. So that can be done using list constructor, that is this. Next, here we can write this function inside this. Okay, so here we can write list filter of, this is the function and this is the iterable. Enter, and here we can see the output in the list form. Okay, so if you want in the tuple form, then here you can mention tuple, then we'll get the output in the tuple form. So here this filter function will return those element for which this function will become true. For example, here range is from 1 to 11, right? So first x value will be 1, so it will check 1 modulus 2 whether it is equal to 0. No, right? So here this function become false, so it won't return that element. It will go to the next element, that is 2. So it will check 2 modulus 2 is equal to 0. Yes, it is true. That's why it returned that element here. So this filter function will extract those elements from the iterables for which this function will return true. So this is about the filter function. And we can see printing this even number can be done in both ways. One is using for loop, one is using filter function. But here, filter is an inbuilt function, so it is faster. Okay? And next, here we can see we use the iterable here, right? But in the filter function, we can use only one iterable. Previously, we discussed about the map function. In that, we can apply map function more than one list or one tuple, right? But here you can apply this filter function only on the one iterable. Okay. For example, if I take two list. Okay, these are my two list and both contains four element. Now I try to use filter function here. Here I'll check, I want to print the element which is greater than 2. Okay, so I'll apply this on list A and list B. I'll enter. Here we can see the error because filter expected 2 arguments, it got 3. So we can apply this filter function only on one iterable at a time. Okay, so this is about the filter function in 3.5.1. And now we'll see how this filter function will work in Python 2. Okay, there is a difference. So here we can see we are using Python 2 and here we already created a list called num. So here now I'll use filter function. So here I'll enter. Here we can see we got output, but in Python 3 we got filter object. So in Python 3, filter function will returns the filter object, but in Python 2 it won't create any filter object, it will directly give the output. Here we can see we got the output in the list form. So this is the difference in Python 3 and Python 2. So next we'll talk about the reduce function. Okay, so as name indicates, this reduce function will reduce a iterable to single element using some functions. Okay, so the output from the reduce function will be a single element. So this can be used when you want to find out the sum of all the elements in the list. Okay, that time you can go for this reduce function. Or if you want to find out the product of all the elements in the list, then you can go for this reduce function. So if you want to perform some computation on the list or tuple, then you can use this reduce function. So next we'll see the syntax of reduce function. So here we need to mention reduce. Next here function. And here iterables. Okay, so iterables are nothing but anything that can be looped over is called as iterable. For example, list, range function, strings, tuples, okay, these are called as iterables. And here this is the function. Based on this function, reduce function will reduce the iterables to single element. Okay, now we'll see the example for reduce function. So in Python 3, this reduce function is defined in a module. So to use this reduce function, we need to import that module. So we need to import that, import the module name is this function tools or func tools. Okay, in this module the reduce function is defined. I'll take one list, okay, called num. I'll take element as 1 2 3 4. Now we'll find out the sum of all the element in the list num. So for that I need to use reduce function. So tool dot reduce. Here I need to mention the function. So here I'll take lambda function. So lambda x comma y, x plus y comma. I need to apply this on the list called num. Okay, so I'll enter. And here we can see the output as 10. So 1 plus 2 is 3, 3 plus 3 is 6, 6 plus 4 is 10. So we got the output as 10. So this will work like this. List is 1, 2, 3 and 4, right? So first it will take x and y. X value will be 1 and y value will be 2. So it will add this. So we'll get 3, okay? In the next step, this will be x and this will be y. So it will add these two. So 3 plus 3, 6, will get 6. Okay, in the next step, this will become x and this become y. So it will add these two and we'll get final output 10. Okay, so it will return this value. Okay, here also, we can apply this reduce function on only one iterable. So here we can see we applied this reduce function on the list num. We can't apply it on more than one list at a time. So for example, if I create another list called, here we can see the error, because here we can see we used two lists at a time, so we got error. So, and in both filter and reduce function, we can apply the function only on the one iterable. So this is about the reduce function in Python 3. So next we'll see reduce function in Python 2. So in Python 2, no need to import any module here. We can directly use the reduce function. Okay. In Python 3, we need to import function tools module. Then we can use the reduce function. But here in Python 2, no need to import any module. We can directly use this reduce function. That is, here we can see reduce lambda x comma y. Here I'll find out the product, okay. And here I'll directly mention the list. That is 1, 2, 3. Okay, this is my list. And enter. Here we can see we got the output. 1 into 2 is 2, 2 into 3 is 6. So here we got the output. So in Python 2, no need to import any module for reduce function. So this is about the reduce and filter function. So that's it for now. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I'll meet you in next class. Till then, take care.